Five Philosophical Greats, a philosophy talk bundle. Descartes, Hume, Kant, Hegel, and Wittgenstein. Five of the most important philosophers of all time.
Each of these thinkers left an important philosophical legacy that resonates through our culture even today.
In this bundle, we explore both the historical legacy and the contemporary relevance of each of these great philosophers.
The 17th century philosopher René Descartes is often considered the father of modern philosophy.
Not only are his meditations a staple of introductory philosophy courses, his arguments for mind-body dualism still resonate with many people.
In this episode, we discuss the life, times, and philosophy of this fascinating French thinker.
Welcome to Philosophy Talk, the program that questions everything.
Except your intelligence. I'm Ken Taylor.
And I'm John Perry. I'm broadcasting from the studio of KALW 91.7, San Francisco's oldest and most innovative public radio station.
And I'm coming to you from Canberra, Australia, one last time, from the studios of the Australian Broadcasting Corporation. It's another cold, chilly winter morning here in Canberra, John. I hope you're having a good day there.
Oh, it's great in San Francisco. Beautiful as always. But I've heard that Canberra is a beautiful city, too. Ken, are you enjoying the beauty?
Well, Canberra, a beautiful city. It's full of beautiful philosophical minds. It's a hotbed of philosophy. It's also full of politicians, so it's a hotbed of hot air, you know. And it's 5 o'clock in the morning here, so my mind's a little slow this morning. So take it easy on me, guy, okay?
Well, you know, you think, therefore, you're awake or something like that. So Australia, San Francisco, Philosophy Talk coming at you from all over the world. And you can also check out our website, philosophytalk.org.
So, John, so we're going to talk about René Descartes today, and he's supposed to be one of the great philosophers of all time, one of the intellectual fathers of the scientific revolution. I mean, so what makes him such a big deal? Tell me a little bit about him.
Well, I mean, there are great things about René Descartes' career that put him up there with Newton and Galileo as a founder of the scientific revolution. We all learn Cartesian coordinate geometry in school and so forth. But philosophically, it's really a change of pace, because philosophically, Descartes is most known for the problem of subjectivity. What's subjectivity? Well, we're all conscious. We all have thoughts and ideas that we're aware of in our own minds. And that was Descartes' starting point. He said, how do I know that there's more to the world than that?
Yeah,
How do I know that there's an external world that I'm perceiving, and it's not just an illusion or some evil demon fooling me? And that really grabbed people's interest.
Yeah, and you're right, it grabbed people's interest. I think of it as a trap, though. I think Descartes says this starts with a problem of subjectivity, right? If I start out knowing my own mind and the content of my own mind, you know, I've got these ideas in there. I've got ideas of tables and chairs and God and my body. I've got all these ideas, and that's the first thing I know. But there's a problem. Are any of these ideas, like, do they have any reference to anything outside of me? Is there really a God? Is there really a table? Is there really a chair? Is there really my body? Are you really out there, John? And, you know, he got us in this trap, but I don't think it's not clear to me he gave us any way to get out of it. And you know, and ever since, people have been wondering, is there a God? Is there an external world? Is there a body?
Well, wonder is great, because wonder is what makes philosophy possible. Don't think of it as a trap or a problem. Think of it as the opportunity of subjectivity, the opportunity that thinking about our own thought and our own existence gives us to think about and understand the rest of the world in a new way. I don't know whether ordinary people are bothered by this, but philosophy students glom onto it right away, and Descartes' very influential.
That's true. Let's find out if some ordinary people are gripped by this. We sent our roving philosophical reporter, Amy Standen, out on a mission. She files this report.
What do you know? Or what do you think you know, and how do you know it? Are you sure you exist? Why?
Well, I guess I do tend to believe what I see and what I've learned through my direct experience, and somehow in the end we know what's a dream and what's not, although I'm not sure how.
You don't, yeah, you don't. I mean, I think you just have to take things for what they are and just, you know, leave it at that. Because you're never, if you think about it that way, you're going to question everything, that, you know, I feel like. I think it would be exhausting to think that way all day, to be honest with you.
Well, I know I exist. Whether this is all that is me, I don't know.
It's true.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.